Listen here. Activity 1, Chapter 2. Already I have finished this first problem. I have finished this activity for first problem. The activity helps you to find HCF of two positive numbers. We first observe the following instruction. Construct a rectangle whose length and breadth are the given numbers. So, first I have completed for 12, 20. 12, 20 I have completed. Now I have taken the 16, 24. For this number I am going to do now. Try to fill the rectangle using small squares. Why they have said that this is a rectangle? Because two different measurements are there. Length and breadth. Isn't it? If both are same inch, you can say that it is a square. They have given. Try to fill the rectangle using small squares. That means equal sides. Try with 1 by 1 square. Try with 2 by 2 square. Try with 3 by 3 square and so on. You can continue this process till you get the side of the largest square. The side of the largest square that can fill the whole rectangle without any gap will be the HCF of the given number. What is the concept? Largest square that can fill the whole rectangle. Largest square that can fill the whole rectangle is the HCF. Now let us check 16, 24. Let us check 16, 24. Here you see. Better you take a graph sheet. It is the better way to do. 24, 16. What they have told you? Try with 1 by 1 square. Already I told you this method. But even then, just for recalling, let us do that. While you are filling up, it is better to fill it with rows and columns. Whether you are able to fill it up with this. Yes. Single square, 1 by 1 square, you can fill it up. Isn't it? This full column, you can fill it up. Similar way, for this also, isn't it? For this also you can fill it up. So how many single squares you can fill it up like this? 16 into 24. That means what? 384, 1 by 1 square can be filled. Just to practice only they have given this. Next what you should do, you have to try with 2 by 2. You have to try with 2 by 2. See. So 2 by 2 also it is possible. Because 16 is divisible by 2. And 24 is also divisible by 2, isn't it? Since they said that it is activity, you can do it and learn. Without doing this also, you will be able to find out the largest square. That I will tell you at the last step. Since you are small children, you try it by, like a game only this is. Like a game only. Yes. Similar way here also. Isn't it? You can fill it up. That means the whole rectangle can be filled like this. With 2 by 2 square. Isn't it? If you are able to fill up this rows and columns like this without any remaining part, then the whole rectangle can be filled up like this. So 2 by 2 also very well you can do it, you can fill it up. I have to finish up within the time, so that only I didn't do. That means 16 into 24 means that is single, 1 by 1. Now 2 by 2, that means divided by 2. That means what? 8 into 12. How many 2 by 2 squares are there? 96 squares are there. That means how many persons you can make arrangement? Let them sit in this floor when you are making a 2 by 2 square. 96 persons. Next, 3 by 3, is it possible? 24 is divisible by 3, isn't it? 8 threes are 24. 16 is it divisible by 3? So, while you are arranging 3 by 3, then you will get a remaining space. Do you want me to do that? Then let me do. See, 3 by 3. Why I have taken this is, because this is 24. This row is 24. So, let me do it with the column. If you are getting remaining, then don't try with this 3 by 3 for the whole rectangle. You see, here it is the remaining part. So, 3 it is not possible. 3 by 3 is not possible for this rectangle shape. Next, what you have to take is 4 by 4. Next, what you have to take? 4 by 4. 16 is divisible by 4, isn't it? That means 4 into 6. 4, 6 are 24. What is it? 4 by 4 square. 24, 4 by 4 square can be arranged in this. Shall I take here? 4 by 4. Here already 2 are there. Is it? 1. Next one is. Two. Next. Three. Next. By row and column, just you arrange and you can find it out without remaining whether you are getting or not. Now you see, completely it is filled up, isn't it? For this side also, it will go because it is divisible, isn't it? Since you said it is activity, just you can do it and see. So, 4 by 4 also is possible, isn't it? Next, 6. 6 is it possible? 6 by 6. Which color shall we take? Let us take both. 6 by 6. Is it divisible by 6? 16 is? No, it is not possible. This is divisible, but even one number, if it is not divisible, then you don't take. Then 7 by 7, is it possible? No, it is not divisible by 7. 16 is also not divisible by 7. 24 is also not divisible by 7. Next, what you have to take? 8. 8 means what? 2 8s are. Isn't it? Here. Sorry. 3 8s are. Let me take another color. It is not clear, I think. Okay. Dark color. Where is this green? 2 8s are 3 8s are 2 threes are 6. 8 by 8. What type of square you are taking? 8 by 8 square. What are all the not possible square? 3 by 3 is not possible. 6 by 6 is not possible. 7 by 7 is not possible. Then 8 by 8. 8 by 8 means what? How you have to take? You see, here 4, isn't it? Next to 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. One. Is it okay? Next. Two. Next. Three. Four. Next. 5. Next. 6. Do you follow? So, which one is the largest square here? 8 by 8 is the largest square. 8 by 8 is the largest square. Therefore, HCF of 16 and 24 is 8. What is the HCF? 8. Because largest square only you must take. One more method is also there. Instead of doing 1 by 1, 2 by 2, 3 by 3, 4 by 4, 5 by 5 like that. Instead, just you see the number. How we are doing in the problem, like that we can do. Euclid division lemma. 16, 24. So first you take 16 by 16 square. First you take 16 by 16 square. Which color let us take? 16 by 16. Isn't it? 16 by 16. What is remaining here? This space is remaining. This space is remaining. Otherwise, let me do it with black. Then it will be clear, I think. This is the remaining space. Isn't it? Remaining is what? 20. Equal to 16 into 1. 116 is 16. 2 6 are 12, remainder 1, then 32 it is coming. Isn't it? So 116 is 16. That means 24 minus 16. That means what? 8. So, you got it. 16. Here you see how many 8s you can do it here. That is 16. Then what? 8. How many 8s? 2 8s are 16. Then what is the remaining? 0. Then what will be the HCF? 8. So, what square you have to take it here? 8 by 8 square you have to take it. You have to take 8 by 8 square. See. How many 8 by 8 squares are there? 2 8 by 8 squares are there. Do you follow? Instead of doing 1 by 1, 2 by 2, 3 by 3 like that, with the help of Euclid division lemma, you have studied. With the help of that, just you draw like this. That is what we have studied. A equal to BQ plus R. A is greater than B. So here you have to take B part because A is bigger, isn't it? Just you choose it like that, the largest possible square, very well you can find it out easily. Do you follow, every one of you? So, but since they have given like this, I tried like this, and also you are all small children, like a game you try to play and understand the concept, why it is unable to do with 3 by 3, 6 by 6, 7 by 7, like that and all, you can learn it. Suppose if it is a competition or within a time you must do means, just you can choose this method, the second one, Euclid division lemma. Do you follow?